Hello YouTube, welcome back to the channel where Yoshi's goal is to get a million subscribers. Okay, so let's just cut to the chase and hit that subscribe button. Because Yoshi said so, and she also says please. As you can see, I'm a pug mom, I'm a cosplayer, and I'm a personal trainer. Okay, we don't have time for this today. Trisha Paytas has called me out on TikTok, apparently. And we are gonna talk about that, but first, let's see what Trisha's been up to. Does that sound good, Yoshi? Sounds good to her, sounds good to me, sounds good to you, let's go. So she is still just another dumb blonde, but with a brain. She is now best frenemies with H3H3. They dress up like each other. Her boyfriend, who I think is H3H3's wife's brother, are now dating.
No, hey, does that look like you like me at all? Put like your arm around me or something. But yes. Come really close. Okay. And come close like you like me.
No, I don't want to pretend.
You're so mean. Oh my god, it's so mean.
Honestly, I stand this. They're cute. She is one of these hop creators on OnlyFans, and she kind of teased us a little bit with a Borat cosplay. So if you're interested in that, I would say check it out. I heard Trisha's OnlyFans is very top tier, and she puts a lot of work and effort into her content. Hashtag not sponsored. I can't put this one on here. She's telling us to vote though with vote stickers around her nipples. She has a new EP called Sad Boy, and whoever's in there has tape also around their nipples, getting surgery by two zombies, which I'm all for. I might just cosplay as one of Trisha's nurse zombies, specifically the one with the boob. And just scrolling through her YouTube really quick, she's still eating. Thanksgiving alone, Panda Express, Red Lobster, Chick-fil-A, and more. And now to this week's drama. So there is a TikToker who is extremely famous for this. This. All I gotta do is smile. You ain't want me back. And this. And whatever else is on her TikTok profile. She's only 16 years old and has 101.1 million followers. People love her and her content. Holy. How the hell are these people getting so famous? Okay, so Charli and her family are those type of rich people who have a private chef. The private chef served Charli and her sister and also very young girl escargot, or snail. He served them cooked Gary, Larry, and Jerry.
Gary and Larry are real different than Jerry.
And they acted like this.
What is this? A snail.
It is a snail.
Oh! This happens when...
And now people are extremely mad at Charli and her sister because of the way they reacted, and they seem extremely ungrateful for the life that they have. And were very rude to the chef. While during this dinner video, Charli said that the fact that she's yet to reach 100 million followers on TikTok, which is a milestone she'd hoped to accomplish within a year of hitting the 1 million mark, people looked at that as very ungrateful and that she thinks of her followers as just a number. Commenters bashed the D'Amelio sisters for their behavior in the video, and Charli ended up losing nearly 1 million followers, going down from 99.4 on Wednesday to 98.5. Well, as you can see from a few minutes ago, like I said, she is now at 101.1. As of me posting this video, maybe she's gonna freak out about something else and people will get upset and then they'll unfollow her. You guys unfollow people very quickly. It's so odd. Anyway, so now you're probably asking, where does Trisha fit into this? She doesn't, but she has forced herself into this situation. Trisha now runs a drama page basically on TikTok and does a lot of commentary type videos, TikTok style. Some people are living for it, me being one. Some people are like, ooh, Trisha, what are you doing? You commenting on how other people are acting on the internet? Odd, the way that you carry yourself. Is basically what people are saying. But on her TikTok account, she goes after everyone. James Charles.
Oh, had to come back because our favorite forever victims, James Charles, subtweeted this about me.
Liza Koshy.
Okay, so let me know if I'm the only one that has a problem with this. When creators who create regularly take breaks or leave the internet, Liza Koshy is definitely one of those people. They come back and make a video to promote a lot. And the only video she's really posted is to promote other stuff. A dance show, her movie on Netflix, and her political beliefs.
No one is safe, including me and Charli. We'll get to mine in a second, but she had an issue with the way that Charli reacted to the snails, like a lot of Charli's fans did, which I think is hilarious. Imagine getting called out by Trisha Paytas, someone who acts like this on the internet.
Push me on a fire, baby. This pig's ready to get rammed.
And she tells you to do better, to be better, to act better.
The kiss craziest footage you ever seen of any aliens out there.
I can't. Probably one of the last people who should be critiquing and telling people how they should present themselves on the internet, but it's the internet. Anybody can comment on anything and make this their job. And Trisha has. People were saying that Trisha is double the age of Charli and she is bullying her for calling her out like this. Apparently the whole snails thing was actually a joke by Charlie's family.
Since they are role models on such a big platform, they should be called out when they need to be humbled a little, because you see this happen all the time. People get really famous, a lot of followers really quickly. They think they're entitled to 100 million. They complain that they only have 95 million followers. They complain that they have a personal chef. And it's just unbecoming.
Those girls are the greatest. I love them.
Okay.
It was all fun and games.
Were your feelings hurt, or how did you, I mean?
Not at all. Not at all. I mean, I don't expect them to love the snails. Like I said, somebody, I'm not going to say who.
Oh, this guy right here.
Thought it would be funny to feed them snails.
They apparently told the chef to serve them snails because they knew that they would act very dramatically. Okay, and between you and me, you know, we're friends. We eat hot Cheetos occasionally together, along with, you know, something healthier, like protein shakes. We like to talk and eat junk food in moderation over here. So let's just channel our 16-year-old self. I'm pretty sure, actually 100% sure, that I would act very dramatic if someone served me Gary on a plate.
Gary, why did you have to go?
Actually, mini story time. When I was around probably 13 or 14, my family finally took me on the Disney World cruise. So I was super excited. When you eat dinner on a cruise, if you don't have enough people in your family, then other people sit at your table. And we had a very cute older friend couple who was just loved Disney, loved cruises. Both of their husbands have passed away and they were just going on a cruise together, having a girl trip. I remember them to this day. They were awesome. But one of the ladies ordered these big, slimy looking, still like circled up snails. And they might have been smaller than this, but to my 13 and 14 year old brain, they were like this. They look nasty and slimy, and I couldn't stop staring at her plate. And I'm almost positive I probably said, oh my god, that's disgusting. Like the stupid teenager I was, because I don't know about you when you were teenagers. Maybe you guys just acted perfectly and knew exactly what was the appropriate way to react to every single situation in your 16-year-old life. But I will just say that I didn't, and I probably could have reacted better in certain situations. But you know what? Teenagers and sometimes adults don't always do that. Sometimes they're caught by surprise and they react dramatically. I don't watch Charli. I don't even like TikTok that much, but I hate how you people. Oh yeah, we're going there. I said it. You people. You odd people that are so quick to get enraged by anything you see on the internet and act all high and mighty as if you are 100% squeaky clean. When I saw all this drama, I was like, dang, something must have really been bad, because losing 1 million followers in such a short amount of time, unfollowing you, this was probably crazy. Can't wait to hear about it. Snails. Because she didn't want to eat snails. Really, people? Is that you? Tell me, were you one of those people unfollowing someone because they didn't want to eat snails and they reacted a little dramatically? I probably can name like 5 teenagers in my life that would act this way. Actually, I went to YouTube and just looked up people trying escargot, and the reactions were either, gross but tastes okay, or similar to Charli's, because snails are not a normal part of the American diet. Hot Cheetos dipped in ranch are. They were little kids.
Ew. It kind of looks like poo.
Buzzfeeders.
And what? No, I'm not gonna eat this.
Oh, this is fitting, TikTokers.
No, no way. I basically ate it. That's disgusting.
And looky here, Trisha trying escargot, and she flipped out.
Okay, we got escargot, and I was really excited that they're gonna look like little snails, but it looks like the swamp the snails live in.
I'm just kidding. She actually liked them. But homegirl likes anything in butter, okay?
It actually is really good.
Butter and garlic.
But anyway, I can't imagine my life being so outraged by this.
What is this?
This is a snail.
Even Wendy Williams chimed in.
I don't feel sorry for her.
I was gonna ask, do you think this backlash is warranted? Yes.
Charli was getting death threats and people took this as Wendy saying she deserved the death threat. I don't think she meant that at all. I think she meant people should tell her to tone it down if you don't like a certain food and respectfully say no thank you. But that's how people decided to take it. Anyway, back to Charli and Trisha. See, I know it's fair game. We're all in the public eye. We're all gonna get critiqued. But I can't seem to just scratch off this itch telling me that Trisha and others are a little jelly that a little 16-year-old girl got 101 million followers by doing this. And Trisha got famous by doing this.
Oh my god. I'm not being dramatic. This is the only place with lighting. You blocked me. Or for me, she asked him if he's okay, so he must have known I was over there. And I
And now Trisha is latching onto anything that's possibly slightly offensive to anything Charli does so that she can act mad on the internet. I cannot relate. She reacted how so many teenagers would react.
That was the worst thing I've ever had.
Well, there it is. Someone needs to drop this asshole's Instagram so I can make sure to tell him to check his privilege.
Have you ever tried whole grain bread? It's far better for you. Not everyone can afford organic stores, Carmen. Maybe you should check your privilege.
Anyway, she was getting death threats over this. People were saying you should think of other people in other countries. They don't have the privilege that you have. And I'm sure she's extremely rich, but she's still 16, having people tell her to, herself.
Like, this is messed up stuff that people are saying. Like, people telling me to hang myself, people just like blatantly disrespecting the fact that I'm still a human being is not okay at all.
And I just wanna say, those people, ew. But does this offend you? Oh my god. If it does, why are you here? You're probably stressed out watching this channel. I probably offend you every single day. I'm sorry. I'm not. Let's move on. So after all the snail drama, Trisha was still going hard on Charli. She apparently posted multiple videos, quote unquote, attacking Charli and her sister. And she appeared on the H3H3 podcast. Remember, they are best frenemies now, and they dress like each other. After Trisha constantly calling Charli out on her TikTok about how she should be acting on the internet, Charli ended up calling out Trisha and danced to a voiceover of Trisha saying some racial slurs. As in pretty much saying, please don't tell me how to act on the internet. You are the last person to say how I should be acting with your past. And then people got upset, plot twist, at Charli. And Trisha saw that people got upset and used it to her advantage. So on the H3H3 podcast, where Ethan was even like, why are people giving her this much flack about this?
You weren't the first one. I saw tons of people before I saw yours. And my initial reaction was like, what the, who the, why are you giving this poor girl such a hard time?
Anyway, she said a few things. One being she's obviously not a racist because she was on Big Brother and they make sure that there's no racists on their show. Trisha logic. Two, she's way more mature than Charli because she got candles shoved up her backside. Three, call Charli the R word.
Oh, that's like retardation, not to be mean. Like, I don't know, I'll probably get canceled for saying that, but yeah, like there is something a little off with her, right?
Ethan corrected her and I actually really like how it was handled. People are going to say some things that maybe they don't understand as offensive or it slips out or whatnot.
Wait, you just called her retarded.
But I think there's something like maybe off with her. Because
yeah, but
no way...
but that's an offensive word.
No, but I think there's an actual slowness there.
Yeah, but retarded is a derogatory word.
I don't think it came from a place of hate for people who have certain conditions. I think it came from a place called the early 2000s where people use it to call someone stupid. Just like I cannot stand the N-word said by anyone, but some people think it means, hey friend. My friends don't address me like that. They just address me by my name. But I guess some people have different types of ways they, address their friends. But with that being said, I do like how it was handled. Ethan corrected her. She said sorry.
You could call her slow, but if you use the R word, it's rude.
I apologize.
And they moved on, but people were upset about it. So does Trisha saying the R word offend you? Now to the tea. I got so many messages saying, Michelle, this is hilarious. Trisha called you out. Oh my gosh, Trisha's pissed. Michelle, she posted you on TikTok. OMG, Michelle, Trisha's giving you free publicity. You gotta react to this. I was like, oh yes, honey. React, go in. I want to see you respond to my critique. And of course my clown cosplay. and my unicorn cosplay, and my Megamind cosplay, and the Queen of Hearts. I seem to always dress up when it's a Trisha video. She's a fellow dresser-upper, so whenever I talk about her, I feel like I need to dress up, and now I feel very underdressed. Next time, Trisha, I'll make it good. Anyway, let's watch her roast me. Okay, a few things. You guys made that sound like it was way more intense than what that was. She did the traditional TikTok procedure of not saying anything and just kind of pointing, and pretty much just confirmed that she is a clown because she dresses up like a clown. I'm guessing there is really nothing to say because she really is a clown. And I think next time I'm going to switch it up and dress up as a troll. Because she's that too. I still think she's funny. I don't take anything she does seriously. I'm not too sure why people get mad at her. She's a troll clown. Trisha the troll slash clown. Trisha, you need to cosplay as a troll slash clown? It would be so fitting. I could help you morph into your true form, girl. I'm just kidding. But it'd be pretty funny. Bye. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. You see the drippy, I'm fitted up. Hop in my car and a giddy up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. You see the drippy, I'm fitted up. Hop in my car and a giddy up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. Ooh, I've been on the flex since flex zone. Neighborhood all in